Catherine Teagan Books and Harper Audio present Wondrous Rex by Patricia MacLachlan, performed by Cassandra Morris. We can find magic in the sunrise, the full moon, a kindness, someone's laughter, and even in a dog who doesn't talk. 1. Flummoxed. I am 7 years old, and my life is soon to be full of wondrous happenings. Wondrous is a word I learned from my Aunt Lily, a writer of books. Lily lives next door to me, and I go there after school while my mother and father are at work. They are pediatricians, doctors for children. My friend Daniel calls us the doctor-doctor family. My parents deal with tonsils, broken bones, blood, and children who throw up on them. My Aunt Lily deals with words. She loves words most of the time, and she has taught me many words, such as melancholy, delirious, and of course, wondrous. My teacher, Ms. Luce, is often impressed, but not too impressed. "You know fine words, Grace," she says. "Now why don't you weave them into a story?" She hands me a journal of empty pages. My name, Grace, is on the cover. "I don't know how to write a story," I say. "Only my aunt knows how." Ms. Luce smiles. "I know you better than you think," she says. "You have stories inside you. You'll find a story or a poem to share one day." When I let myself into Lily's house, she has baked 36 frosted ginger cookies and laid them out in rows, and she is eating dill pickles out of a glass jar. Lily always bakes and eats dill pickles when her writing is not going well. "I'm flummoxed, Gracie," she says. Another word. "I don't know what new story to write. I'm like a sailboat without a sail. I'm wandering. I need help. Flummoxed." She eats another pickle. "You will think of something," I say. "I have put up a notice in the post office, on a grocery bulletin board, and also online for an assistant," Lily said. "Help yourself to a cookie." She shows me the printed notice. "A writer of books needs an assistant, a coach, a helper for inspiration and some magic." Lily's email address and contact information are written below the notice. "An assistant?" I ask. "Well, a coach, maybe, to help me write." I see that her desk is a mess of papers and two coffee cups and books. One book is a writer's help book titled, "What Now?" "Maybe your writer's group will help," I say. Lily shakes her head. "Maybe. But this has to come from me, in some new way." She sighs. "I want magic," she says. Later, Lily and I will remember her word, magic. It turns out to be the very word she gets. Magic. 2. The L's. It is a half day at school, and Lily's writer's group is coming over to her house afterward. I love it when they come. They don't ask me to sit in the group. I might learn their secrets. Lily puts me at the dining room table, behind glass doors, closed a bit. But I am 7 years old, don't forget, and I have sharp hearing. I call the group the L's because all their names begin with the letter L. Laura, Lois, Lila, Lacey, Lou, Lana, and my Aunt Lily. They write novels for adults and for children, essays, and poetry. They eat snacks and talk about their news before they read their work aloud. Sometimes I take notes or draw pictures of them. Sometimes their news is very dramatic, as Lily puts it. Lily loves my drawings, and she frames them. One says, "Sold," and has bright stars all around. The other says, "Rejected," and has gray teardrops. The news today is this. My editor did not want my book, says Laura. I spoke at a conference last week, and my day job is troublesome. No writing, says Lois. It's spring. I work in my garden instead of writing, says Lila. She crosses her legs and bounces one leg up and down. She wants to go back to her garden. I sold 3 picture books, sent out another, says Lacey. I have poems to read today, says Lou. I was too tired to write, says Lana, yawning. But I
have some. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.